To be a projectionist, you have to have sort of you have to be quite an introverted person. But a lot of the time you're sitting in a dark booth for 2 hours. It's another world. And there's only a little bit of action at the very start of the film to get that all right. Then there's a long period of about an hour where nothing happens. A little bit of a 5 minute, you know, bit of excitement where you've got change over to the second reel. And then it's just a long period of where nothing happens. So I'll often sit there in the dark and I'll read a book. I'll have a little torch perhaps, or there's actually a secret light there that you can have which doesn't play out through the booth. So yeah, often I'll be sitting in the dark reading. So with the old format films, what we usually get is a very big film that'll arrive and it'll be reeled up, and it often has to be split into two reels. And that's the reason why we used to have intermissions in the old days, is you would have to play one reel, stop, because often the old style cinemas had one projector. You'd have to take that reel off and then put the second reel on, and it would take like 5 minutes, and that's why we had intermissions. We have two projectors, so we can easily go from playing one reel and then switching over to the second one. It is a very strange time because we are going from the old style of having films on reels, and we're moving more towards playing stuff off DVDs even, but often it's on hard drive. So our skills are becoming less and less used because we've been trained how to reel machine, you know, the films up, and more we're getting stuff where you basically just press two buttons. When you're a trainee projectionist, there's often a lot of times where you make your most mistakes. So, you know, I've heard instances where the reel's fallen off and the film's basically just uncoiling on the ground, and you can walk in there if you've been out and find the film booth half full with a film that's unreeled. So that's not good. Not that that's happened to me, but it has happened to others. The worst thing that can happen is if the film actually rips. And that means you've got to basically paste it back together again, which isn't easy.
Has that ever happened to you?
No.
Can you involve that say that's never happened to me?
That's never happened to me, though I've heard of others where that may have happened. I'll often sit in there and I'll look out through the projectionist booth and you'll see the visuals. It's like watching poetry. So you become you develop a language of visuals. Some of the things I really like watching are there's the sort of darky, quirky ones that are quite offbeat, I suppose. It might not be the storyline so much, it's just visual, like little snippets of a film. Like for example in True Grit, where it's got like a woman in a big wide black dress and she's just after the hanging, and just the screenshot of that is incredible. You know, it's little interesting bits of films which actually stay with you after the film. We'll be right back.